to repeat Saturday's poor performance, which left them with a 1-1 draw. But stout Bath defence here by Mike England thwarted many Bristol attacks. As on Saturday, Bristol had the run of play, but Bath looked dangerous on the break. Mike Adams not quite making the most of this chance. Gary Marshall set up several moves for Bristol, here beating two men before going for goal himself. After half an hour, it looked as if Saturday's history might be repeating itself, but then Alan Walsh was brought down in the box. Gordon Owen made no mistake from the penalty spot, and it was more a sigh of relief than a cheer which went round the ground. City, determined not to let a 1-0 lead slip again, continued to pressurise the Bath goal, but too often with over-ambitious long shots. Into the second half, and still Bath refused to give up. They posed several problems for the Bristol defence. With a little luck, this shot by Paul Bowden could have caused an upset. Bristol, though, were in command and laid on a series of shots. Here Walsh to Neville for Gary Marshall to have a go. Bristol on the break again. A loose back pass by Bath's Brian O'Donnell allows Alan Walsh in, and Bristol cries for another penalty. But then Bristol did strike. Gary Marshall with a penetrating run and Steve Neville nipping inside the defence. Relieved at this, Bristol opened up. A neat back heel by Neville and Walsh putting it wide for Paul Fitzpatrick. Then, 4 minutes from time, Gordon Owen sent in a cross rather than a shot, and miserably for Bath, deflected over Dave Mogg's head. Bath out, but far from disgraced, and deservedly quite a bit richer.